Welcome to GB Creations. I am Jackie and this is my YouTube channel. Please subscribe and please go follow me on Instagram. Starting from now, I'm going to start making jewelry reviews and I have my own jewelry brand. Yes, I make my own jewelry. I made this definitely. Today's going to be a little bit of a different video. I'm going to be showing you guys the differences in between a original Michael Kors watch and a replica. So I have two replicas to show you and two authentic Michael Kors watches to show you. So I'm going to start off with the two replicas. So here's a silver Michael Kors watch, which is a replica, and I'm going to show you the rose gold Michael Kors replica. I don't know if you guys can tell already the differences of these replicas, but let me show you the authentic ones. So I just got this watch. I love it so much. It's a red Michael Kors watch. You can tell it's really shiny and really new. I just love it. And then I am also going to show you my rose gold one, which is right here. It's gorgeous. I love it either way. I am so sorry for the background. It's just crazy. So I'm going to start off with showing you some of the flaws of the original Michael Kors. So to begin with the Michael Kors, as you can see right here, the Michael Kors name is perfectly aligned. The letters are perfectly separate and not stuck together like some of the replicas. And I know sometimes you can tell that the middle part or the color of the watch is sometimes ridiculous with the replicas, and you can honestly tell right away. Another thing you can tell right away if it's not authentic is the typing. This is an original Michael Kors and it has a really nice lettering to it, as well as a certain code on there where you open the watch. It has some certain numbers. Another thing obviously is the inside of it. It tells you if there's a code you can type in to check if it's authentic or not. Other than that, the weight of it too, you can tell if it's a real Michael Kors watch or not. The same for this one. Some of them have it on top and some of them have it in the bottom, like this one right here. And obviously the print of it is just amazing and new and good. I know it's a little bit blurry, I'm sorry you guys. And obviously the same with the print in the front. It has the even and the beautiful shiny things on the side, which is the little diamonds. So this is the authentic one. So I'm now showing you the replica one. And of course, the original ones come in this really nice Michael Kors box, and as well with a little book and a little tag on the side. And it also has Michael Kors in there. And I believe some of the boxes, I think, have like even the number, a certain number typed on the bottom for authentic. So to begin with the replica, you can see obviously by the paint that it is not as real as an original Michael Kors. See, we can compare. This is a little bit too much shiny than this one. Let's see, what else can I show you? I can also show you there is no number. This is the replica. You can see there is no number and you can totally tell the material type. And as well as an original and a fake on there. This is the replica. I don't know if you can really see it, but this one is a little bit like typed out than this one. This one's a little bit more done professionally. And some other things I'm gonna tell you, I mean, you can't really tell on here, but the color from inside is kind of coming off. And this little thing right here, they're little glitter spots and they're usually like little diamonds and little crystals around there. And as well as the name on the bottom, it's a little bit uneven, so you can obviously tell when it's a real one or not. This can trick you sometimes. I think this, a lot of other Michael Kors watches have it as well, but mostly they have it on the side right here, so don't get fooled yet. I think the silver one is what has it in the middle, so don't fall for it. For this one, it's the same thing, it's too shiny. There is no number on there compared to my rose gold original one. There's like a number and this one doesn't have it. And as well as this one, the way it's typed, you can see the lettering is like smudging up, so not good. And you can tell the little box right there, because some of the watches have dates. This one has a really small box compared to this, the authentic one, my rose gold, has a little bigger box than that one. I don't know if you can really see it. This is terrible lighting, you guys. So here's that. For this one, the little parts and the paint also is fading away, as well as a little part missing on there. I don't think they're supposed to do that. Another thing, another little detail I would like to show you guys is the typing on it. This is the replica one. The typing on there has a different font and a different style than the original one on there, so it's best for you guys to know. Yes, I will definitely leave pictures side to side with the replica and the original for you guys to see the differences. So this is just a little bit of help to show you guys how to tell which one's authentic and which one's original. I want to help you guys out, that way you guys won't get tricked into buying a fake Michael Kors. And like always, just you guys gotta watch out. And it's the same with the bags and wallets, just like I could put on reviews of a fake Gucci wallet versus an authentic one. This is an authentic one. If you guys want me to be showing you guys stuff like that.